Streaming once again this week. As you should be aware, I'm not doing a deck building challenge. I'm instead playing some random quests. In 2 weeks' time, I'll be going back to the 6 AP challenge, which I started 2 weeks ago. And so I'll be doing another couple of quests then, and then back to some random quests, and then back to the challenge, and hopefully finish it off. This time round, instead. Okay, I've now edited this deck to put the heroes in the right order since I updated it. I'm going to be playing my Int deck against a few quests. You can feel free to suggest quests, though I already have a few in mind. I could have sworn that I copied the URL for deck so that I could post it, but apparently not. And I will just get that. But it's called Hasten the Ents. It's my Ent deck. It's built around, obviously, Leadership Faramir having the ability to ready allies when you engage enemies, and Ents entering play exhausted. So there's obviously a good combo there. And then it also. There we go, there's the link to the deck. It also works well with Mablung and Pippin, both also triggering when you engage enemies. So, okay, this is a pretty good opening hand. So, for quests, I think I'm going to start by playing the old forest, following that age-old proverb of set a tree to catch a tree. That's a terrible joke, but I really like making it. So, yeah, I need to add a location to the staging area. Now, solo isn't necessarily the best way to actually show off this deck, it must be said, because obviously, in solo, you get less enemies, so you don't necessarily engage enemies every round, which means less opportunity to get use out of, well, all three of my heroes. But regardless, this is a good opening hand. I've got an Errand Rider, and Faramir's resources have no real use in this deck. Oh, hang on. I'm not playing in campaign mode, so I shouldn't have Frodo, should I? Go away, Frodo. Go put you in the victory display. I also have Treebeard, of course. He's likewise a very good thing to start with. Okay, draw a card. That's also useful. Have that at the start. And now I need a random stage 2A. So hand this. Here we go, second quest deck. I'm just going to move stage 3 into the second quest deck so that I can just shuffle these. And that's fine. The end of the round has got a random location from the victory display. Okay. So, Errand Rider, and then I would like to get. Actually, no. I can save up for Treebeard. That might be a better idea than immediately playing the Wandering Ent, or not. Okay, so obviously now I have to consider I'm playing solo. I'm not necessarily going to get an enemy right away. So, but if I do get an enemy, then I'll engage that enemy and Mablung will gain a resource, which would mean I would still be able to play Treebeard next round, even if I played the Wandering Ant now. However, if I don't get an enemy, then I'll have just played the Wandering Ant, and next round I still won't be able to play Treebeard. And in fact, I wouldn't be able to play anything, really. I could play the Condor and Shield. But I think I will just save up. And actually, let's play the Gondorian Shield onto Mablung. So, X is one. So, one threat. Let's just quest for four. Deep Gully, that's fine. So, one will retrieve in the stage of my progress, place one will retrieve before it can be placed on the quest, so I only make one progress. I will. Yes, after placing progress, if the result of questing successfully, there are X or more total victory points in the victory square on stage 3, otherwise, a different random stage 2A. X is the number of players in the game, times 5. So, let's shuffle and stick this one on bottom. This is still fine. At the end of the round, remove all progress from each location in play. Alright. Travel to the deep gully. Control N. Play Treebeard. Int has play exhausted. I'll play Int Mute now. Let's put control on Int. It gets me 3 Ent cards. Shuffle these up. And, okay, so now I don't necessarily have to keep Mablung ready to defend with the Gondorian Shield, because I can just ready Treebeard to do that. So I will quest for 6. I don't want to get location locked. Choose 2. At the end of the phase, Razor's place up by X was X. That's the number of enemies in the staging area. Well, that's not a problem. So I'm questing for 6 against 1. I make 4, 5 progress. So this goes to the victory display, but of course I'm just going to keep the victory display over here. After placing progress, I don't have 5 victory points, so let's shuffle. The reason I'm doing this is because if I hit Control Q, if I have the previous quest card still there, then the new quest card would go up here, where I want it to just go here, like normal. So I shuffle first because it has to be a different random stage 2A, and then stick it on the bottom so that I get the top one. And we're back to this one. Okay. Well, I guess I'll travel to the Wall of Trees since I don't have any other location. Oh! Last round I should have removed all progress from play, which was one last round. At the end of this round, this location is discarded from the victory display, so I'm back to 0 victory points. That's fine, okay. So, let's see. I think maybe I want to prioritize getting out some combat power, so I'm going to earn Rider a resource to Mablung and spend those 3 to play Skinbark. And then quest for 6. This is 1, so 5 progress. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm up to 1 victory point. I shuffle these. Stick this on the bottom and put a new one. At the end of the planning phase, each player must exhaust a hero he controls. This is pretty bad in solo, but... Well, at least I didn't start with it. It would have been more of a problem if I'd started with it. Now I travel here. At some point, I'm sure combat will actually happen. But so far, obviously, it's not. Let's get down the booming end. And also a Welling Hall Preserver. At the end of the planning phase, I'll exhaust Pippin, and then I'll still quest for 6. This is 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2 victory points. Shuffle. Thing is, I haven't played this deck for a while, so I wanted to pick a fairly easy quest for it, just to start me off and make sure he's getting in the right mindset and not screwing everything up. Okay, this is just making this take longer, which is kind of annoying. Entmoot, draft, and another Entmoot. And Entmoot again. Glendingle Warrior, Quick Beam, Ent draft. Alright, so we got there, play the Glendingle Warrior. And play the Ent draft onto the Glendingle Warrior. Because it can always use more hit points. Four, six, nine. Player is a character who controls from a person deals 2 damage. 3 of that character is an ally. Okay, so I guess I'll deal 2 damage to Mablung. No, I will make it better. So this is explored, and I need to go to another random stage. Number of locations in the staging area is less than the number of players in the game. So let's go grab a wall of trees again. And a wall of trees are in the... Oh no, they're not all in this part now. There we go. Actually no, I'm going to travel, so... Okay, a passive forest. Let's go for a passive forest. They reveal another encounter card. Travel here. Control N. Natural resource there. It's just a compromise things a bit. Alright, so let's move the resource to Pippin. And then between Pippin and Treebeard I can play Wandering Ancient Quick Beam. Quest 30 for 6, 8, 11. 2, so. Oh no, sorry, I reveal an extra card. An enemy! Okay, so... Full threat. I still won't make enough progress to explore this. Which puts me up to 4 victory points. I need 5 to advance the quest, so... Go to a different random stage, 2A. More progress from each location in play, that's fine. Oh, and off the active location is playing the explored location, makes it easy to attack. So let's defend with Dame Dingle Warrior, deal a damage for its effect. Plus 2 of the defending characters and allies, so attacking for 6. 1 more damage. Now I will travel here and I will engage this enemy, adding resource to everyone drawing a card and readying an ally with Faramir. So let's ready Treebeard. Treebeard will defend, spin play, start each. That's. Well, that has the potential to be a really harsh shadow effect for this deck. It's actually not that bad in this particular context because it's a decent way into the game and I've played most of the allies in my hand. But I needed 2, I can attack for 7. So we ended up to 5 attack total. Draw in when the Werewolf Preserver readies, heal a damage from Ent character. There we go. Draw some of Darren's runes. Don't need all 3 boomed and trumpeted. Darren's runes. Don't need both Gandalf's. Save Sneak Attack Gandalf for dealing with Old Man Willow. That's for resource to Pippin. Pay 3 for Beachbone. And give him an Ent Draft. And now. Okay, when I explore this, I will advance to stage 3, so let's just hop to 6. 13. Okay, so this is explored. And I advance to stage 3. And Old Man Willow and Gingle. X and counter cards where X is the number of players in the game minus 1, so none. Well, then the low, because it's being a good player, attacks each player in the combat phase, that's fine. Trying to Willy Windle. Okay, it's just while it's active, I reveal another card during the quest phase. Doesn't actually have a travel cost, but. I explored the active location, so this guy is attacking me. Wait. I used the Iron Rider to move a resource to Pippin, didn't I? Which I clearly should not have done because the whole point was I was saving Sneak Attack Gandalf. Zoomed perk out effects. So, in the combat phase, I want the Dane Dingle Warrior to defend Old Man Willow. I could faint the long trailer. In the combat phase, that is. Oh no, wait, I can have Gandalf defend Old Man Willow. So, yeah, then in the wild we'll defend now. Now I drop some attachment, he controls. Use the shield. Triggering the Gandalf Willow's effect. Now I will travel to Rivendell and engage this long trailer, gaining a resource strength card, readying Beach Bone. And now let's sneak attack Gandalf. Draw three more cards. Gandalf can defend against Old Man Willow. It's fine. We'll paint the long trailer. Obviously, I had. Oh, we're not going to start running with the display. Random number 1 to 4. 2. So there's my thought by 2. Now, of course, I have no actual need to kill Old Man Willow. But I can. Anyways, we need to play a card like this, so I can't actually use Beach Bone on him effectively. But I could still trigger Beach Bone's effect if I wanted to. So, say I attack for 4, 7, 9, trigger Beach Bone, which. I don't actually know if I can do that when it won't have any effect. Alternatively, okay, so I attack for 3, 5 against the long trailer, triggering a beach bone, dealing the damage to him steel. Add damage to the long trailer. Did I kill one of these early with 6 attack? It takes 8. I think I had spare attack for like, whatever. This is up to 6 attack. Yes, so that both points. So I'll do that, and this is up to 6 attacks, so I'll deal 2 damage to Old Man Willow for no particular reason. Pretty well, was I lucky with the Dawn Bringer Warrior? Warrior and another Wormhole Preserver. And quest. Okay, I need 18 progress here. And 5 here, and I'm revealing the extra card. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 13. Surge and the extra card. Choose your pattern loop to change the staging area. Choose this one. So I was pressing 15, 3, 4, 7, 8, 7 progress. 5, 6, 7. Travel to the Strange Woods. Have to engage the army of flies, which did not trigger Pippin because of their low engagement cost, but they do trigger Mad Bonnie and Faramir. And have to discard an objective attachment I control, so it'll be this end draft. And I have to. I don't have to maybe a character I control, but I'm obviously going to. So I guess just ready to be it. Turn on the wire and hands against Old Man Willow. Dealing damage. There are no locations there are. And I have to discard a random location from the victory display. One. Maybe I'll be going to Lightways, but I cut by three. I'm just going to defend these with Beach Bone. Okay. Kill the army of flies and burn attack for 10. Willing Hall Preserver heals the Dundee Gold Warrior. Quest phase, I sneak attack Gandalf and drop my threat by 5. Quest 2, 4, 6, 12, 14, 18, 22. I should be looking for in terms of the staging area. Another wall of trees. I was 22, wasn't I? 6, 8, 14, 16, 18, 22. This is 5, 17 progress. 13 and 12 more. 8 more. Not that the sequence really matters, but I'm still sticking with it. Gandalf comes back to my hand. And with this standing old warrior doing the damage. That's fine. 7, 11, 12. 14 attack. I mean, I certainly could bring in another moving int, but I kind of want to just play Gandalf. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Drop my threat by 5 again. Quest 2, 4, 6, 8, 14, 16, 18, 22 again. Oh, I've got to discard one of these when all my will hit me. And another one, 4, 2. I got by 1. Now I'm questing for 22. Remove. So I'm questing for 18, and I make another 15 progress. And win the quest. Okay, that was really pretty easy. But I feel like I'm definitely back in the right mindset for playing this deck. I'm actually in my sideboard. Third Warden of Healing, Seal of Gondor, just for the multiplayer. Side quests, which I could have used. Extra card draw that I don't need that much. Yeah. Okay. So, let's see. Next quest up. I need to edit this deck to put the hero in the right order. It's honestly, this is one of the few things about Ring's DB that bugs me, which is pretty good going, but it does bug me that heroes don't end up in the order that I want them to be in. Let's play the three trials. I really like this quest. It can be pretty rough on a solo deck. But, well, it depends on the deck. And this one manages pretty well. I think every quest I'm actually going to be playing tonight is one which I've done with this deck before. But I haven't done them on stream before. Treebeard and Root. Shield. Reasonable, but no. Iron Rider, that's good. Okay. So, stage 2. Strength, always last. And that's fine, yeah. Location, encounter deck, combat. Always, pretty much always the sequence that I choose. So, random location, random key, random number 1 to 3, 1, random number 1 to 3, 2. So that's location 1, and key 2, wolf. Guardian, which engages me, giving me a draw, so drawing a card. But okay, control M. So now here I definitely want this Gondorian shield. Play and rider. And get down the booming ant right away. And quest, just quest for 4. Actually, is the booming ant right away the best plan? Okay, let's take these back. Let's put that on the other order. Play down the rooms. Okay. Do I come to not necessarily such a good idea in this quest? Though, I suppose the other enemies are not super dangerous. But still, saving up. Okay, so I'm not going to play anything else. Because actually, saving up to get in a better questing ally next round is probably a better plan. So I'm just questing for 4. Okay, I lose by 1. My travel here. I don't have to engage the spirit of the wild. I will. So, okay, let's own rider with the results to Pippin. And then I engage the spirit of the wild, ready the own rider, gain a resource, and draw a card because it's plus 1 engagement cost from Pippin. And then we're going to leave that resource to Pippin as well. So this gets naturally Shadow Carver's attacks. They're all exhausted already. Plus 1 for each key objective, which is none. I take 1 damage. This obviously is undefended, but it's just 1. So do that 1 damage to Pippin. Can't attack back. This is maybe not the most auspicious start, but it will work out, I think. So now, let's play 3 for a Wellinghall Preserver. And then let's play Entmoot. Grab these 4 Ent cards. Oh, yeah, time counters. One of which is just being removed. So now, okay, so the Wand of Healing would be useful, but I think I'm going to prioritize getting out more willpower. So quick beam. And then Dunedain Hunter. So let's go search the top 5 for another Spirit of the Wild. Which I engaged. This will not trigger Pippin this time. Because its engagement cost is 29, factoring in Pippin's ability. And my threat is 29, but I do get to add a resource here and ready this one called Preserver. Which lets me heal this 1 damage off quickly if I want to, but I don't think I want to. Now, I certainly could play this Boon event. But I could also save my blood resources for faint. On the other hand, my chances. Well, if I explore this location, then I'll move to stage 2 and get a new guardian, which will engage me and give me the resource for the faint. So I think I will play the Boon event. Group all my non-end allies under the heroes. So, quest for 2, 4, 7, 9. I think that should be okay. Just got an enemy makes an attack. Okay. I'll throw my Dunedain Hunter under the bus. He's basically done his job already. So I was questing for mine, that's fine. Oh, it should have had an extra shadow card, which was the same thing again. So I take the key of the wolf. That's good to pick him. Pippin can definitely be trusted with significant mystical artifacts. Okay, so. And then number 1, 2, 1, and again 1. So that's the Boar's Guardian and the Cave Barrow. And the Key of the Boar. Don't need the second quest deck anymore, but I do want the special deck. It's right, let's shuffle the discard pile into the deck. Move 14 to the secondary deck. Swap with Incas deck. So this is the bottom 10 cards. Shuffling the key, move all to Incas deck bottom. There we go. Engages me. Draw a card for Pippin. Which ally do I want to ready? Ready with the event. And now. Yeah, I think I want to just travel here. So. Right, so. Not the need to play card effects, so. Let's faint the Guardian. Mabron this, plus one for each key, and it's already plus one for each key, so 3, that's fine. And if the attack is undefended, it's not, no damage. Can't counter attack, do not delete the enemy. Oh, I accidentally added threat instead of time. There we go. Control N. End mute. Excellent. All right, so. Let's go down the Dingle Wire right away and the end draft on it. Now let's press 2, 4, 6, 9. Again. Actually, no, not the end draft because I can save up the Treebeard. Right, so 9, this applies to itself, so it's 3 threat, 6 progress. Combat. Okay, so maybe this isn't going to work out so well for me. Okay. As I said, I have done this before. I think, to be honest, I got kind of unlucky with these popping up early on. I'm going to try it again. Well, I say these. To be fair, one of them I pulled out myself, so I only have myself to blame. To power through trials. More than this. Reorder the quest cards. So, random number 1 to 3. And random number 1 to 3. 3 and 3. Stone barrel. And raven key. That's problematic. But okay. Well, I can play Treebeard right away. And that's obviously a top priority. So now we're gonna have to defend this. So this quest for 4. Time for. And I have to remove a time counter because there is no notification. Travel here. Shadow defend. It's undefended, it's not. I take 1 damage and I raise my threat by 3. Draw aim. There's also some Treebeard. Okay. So, yeah, let's just get down the wandering ant right away. And quest for 6. And some 5 progress. Now they engage here. I'll go to the wandering ant. Actually, no. I will take Spirit of the Wild undefended. Strike counter, 1 damage here. And 24 is here. Okay. Exhaust counter controls. Okay. So much for that. I could have gotten some damage on the Spirit of the Wild, but never mind. And I have to raise my threat by another 3. Okay. Beach bone. And 2 from another wandering it. Quest 8. Okay, yep, 8. Oh, I haven't been removing time counters. Oh, and actually, no, sorry, I don't put that undefended damage on, but then I do put it on. So hang on, which round is it? It's round 3, so I should have removed another one of these. And now I have to remove another one. Matching art with the Rank Guardian. What was I pressing for? 6, 8. Which is enough. Give Keith Raven to Pippin. This is going to advance the quest. So, and then number 1 to 2, and 1 to 2, 1 and 1. So, that's the Boar's Guardian. Not that. Here four. So shuffle into the encounter deck. 15 secondary swap. Given that it's shuffled, technically obviously it doesn't matter the parameters, so I could just move 10 and not have to do the swap, but it doesn't really make that much of a difference how long it takes, and this is technically the correct way. Let's travel to the hill barrow. So of combat, I will obviously sneak attack Gandalf. And I'm just gonna draw cards. Let's Entmoot. Here, Entmoot is just ridiculous in a full-on end deck. Okay, so attacking for 4. He's attacking for 2. Yeah. Okay. This will. Beachbone will defend against the Spirit of the Wild. Plus 1 for each key, so that's okay. 3. 2 damage to Beachbone, that's okay. Treebeard will defend against the Ball's Guardian. 1 damage. I play 1 for Boomed and Trumpeted. Readying Treebeard. With plus 3 attack. So he doesn't actually even need help to take down the Spirit of the Wild, and Gandalf is not actually doing anything. Let's play Entmoot again. Quick heal, and another Entmoot, which I'll play. Grab Treebeard. Gandalf's back in my hand. Oh. Down to wounds. Okay. Unfortunately, I don't quite have enough resources to hard cast Gandalf. Which could be useful at this point because I could have Gandalf just satisfy the time effect on the Ball's Guardian and be discarded, since he is discarded at the end round anyway. But I can't do that, so let's see, Dendingle Warrior is definitely a high priority. And I'll put the Ink Draft on it. Now, questing 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Deal 1 damage to each non-unique character in play. Okay. That was for 10, so 6 progress goes here. Oh! There's Guardian Chief fighting Metal Shadow Cloud last round. Which we. Destroys character. 2 additional Shadow Cards. 2 additional Shadow Cards, plus 1 HP. Two additional shots. It's undefended and nothing. Okay. Given that I want to make my way through the encounter deck, that was actually beneficial. So, 6 progress goes here, and 4 discards from the encounter deck. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Should be able to defend again. That's my HP. So 5 attack. Can really do some healing. Okay. I will attack with Beach Bone. Yeah, I'll attack with Beach Bone. Triggering his response. At the end of the round, with the time counter, discard this one being int and put 2 more time counters on. Yeah, because I haven't had the cave battle yet, so I have to become careful about my ally count anyway. Extra resource on here. Hardcasting Gandalf is pretty tempting at this point. Can't afford a one hit preserver. Okay, let's put an end draft onto Beachbone. Now I could play Glundering Shield. Okay, I'm going to play Genodyne Hunter. Look at my top 5 cards. There we go, Spirit of the Wild. Shuffle. Gain resource. Oh, that doesn't. There isn't an ally that I could have played. So yeah, I guess Faramir's ability gets wasted in this instance. So let's see. Yeah, I need to just drop Gandalf. Could be right. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Gandalf. And draw 3 cards. One of healing. Stone Runes, and there's the Iron Rider, and let's also put a Glundering Shield onto Nablung. Actually, no, let's not put a Glundering Shield onto Nablung, at least not right now. So, quest 2, 4, 6. 8. It's 3. I still make 5 progress. 2, 3, 4, 5. And travel here. Get shadow cards. So okay, I'm throwing the Moonbound Hunter under the Guardian. And the Deadly of the Wild will defend against the Spirit of the Wild. Okay. Shuffle it back into the encounter deck. So, let's see. Now, if I attack with Beach Bomb, I can trigger his response, which would deal 4 damage instantly. Which would take 7 damage, so I'd need to be attacking 4, 7. Which would require both of my other allies. On the other hand, I'm pretty much guaranteed to get the key next round if I just quest hard enough. Although, I mean, I do have to make it through the active location. So maybe I do want to just take out the Guardian right now. Yeah, I do have to trigger Beach Bone in order to take down the Guardian fully. On the other hand, I certainly can bring down the Spirit of the Wild. Let's go. Yes. So the boss guardian is dead. And then I discard Gandalf. Draw in. And okay, so now Eren Rider. Hawk Observer. There's a problem here, where I'm going to have too many allies for the Cave Baron. So, okay, I'm going to play the Warden of Healing rather than the Wailing Hall Preserver. Let's put the shield onto Mablung. And now we quest 13, 4, 6, 8. Okay, there's the key. So I advance the quest. So here comes the Wolf's Guardian. And the Cave Barrow. Gain a resource. Probably should have healed first so that I could ready the warden more, but didn't think of it, and I draw a card. It's obviously a handy point in this quest for this deck, well, for Pippin in general, but Guardians have an engagement cost of 50, so they will always let you draw a card. Okay, so that was my staging. I was questing for 8. I make 5 progress. Can't travel here. Power locations can't be the active location, and I need to play card effects. This guy's 3 attack here. Why did I put the shield on Mavlon and then quest with him? I didn't think it through is the answer to that. Okay, so let's see. Deadly the Wire will defend against Wolf's Guardian. Okay, doing damage. So it's 5 defense. It only lasts for the 1 attack. I could now ready it with Wounded Trumpeted to defend the other attack. But I don't think I'm going to. I'm just going to defend with the 1 minute. Oh, no, hang on, yes. Right, yeah, so the Cave Barrow, I now have too many allies, so I'm actually discarding my Errand Rider. Yep, okay, so that's 1 more damage. The Warrior and Treebeard. So, we'll make it 1 moment. And let's just get rid of the Spirit of the Wild so that I only have the 1 enemy to worry about. Control aim. Another sneak attack. Unfortunately, I can't really use it because that would give me a 5th ally. All I can do is power up the allies that I already have. So maybe that additional int draft could be a good idea. Let's put this int draft onto Treebeard. Now, I only need to tread water as far as questing goes. So, 6. Remove the time counter, or return the active location, so I remove the time counter. And yeah, I quested fine. Okay. Yep, let's defend the Dending Warrior again. Plus 1 for each key. So that's attacking it for 7. So if I deal damage to you, okay. Yeah, okay, so let's just go about pretending the warrior is dead. Now, I can attack for 2, 6, 8, and I can trigger Leech Bone's ability, which would deal another 5 damage. Yeah, I'd effectively be attacking for 13, which is not enough. I could sneak attack Gandalf. I could sneak attack Gandalf to do direct damage. So, let's think about this. If I sneak attack Gandalf to do direct damage, now I would only need 11. 5 of that can come from Beach Bones direct damage. Okay, so sneak attack Gandalf. Deal 4 damage to the Wolf's Guardian. Now I declare an attack with Gandalf and Beach Bone, and I trigger Beach Bone's response, dealing damage to him to deal 5 damage to the enemy. I'm attacking for 6 against 3 defense, so I deal another 3 damage. So the Wolf's Guardian is dead. I attach the key of the wolf. I add Cave Barrow to the victory display, and I advance the quest. And I bring back all three guardians. So, remove all the damage, put the time counters back, and now I just engaged enemies. So, well, Pippin doesn't have a limit, so I draw 3 cards. I gain 1 resource, and I can ready 1 ally. Oh. No, sorry, I'm also going to go back and say I used Wounding Trumpeter to ready Beach Bone when I dealt him the damage from his ability. So now the ally I will ready using Faramir will be Gandalf. So now I can also heal up Beach Bone and Treebeard. So which of these guardians do I want dead? How much can I attack for? I can deal 5 direct damage again. And I can attack 2, 6, 10, 12. That's definitely enough to kill any of them. What are the chances of me being able to kill multiple of them? It's trickier. Okay, so let's say the Boar's Guardian. He has the least number of time counters. So if I deal the 5 direct damage to him with Beach Bone, then I still need to be attacking for 9. Oh, yes, no, Beach Bone, because of Wounding Trumpeted, is 5 attack now. So that's fine. And I could play Wounded and Trumpeted again, even. So let's see how I deal with this. So attacking for 7. Yep, because Beach Bone is now 8, Beach Bone is 2, so I'm attacking for 10. Back to the victory display with you. So now Beach Bone is 8 attack, I have a total of 16 attack, Which once again is enough to kill either of these. Raven Guardian is less dangerous and has less time counters, so. And takes less to kill, so. Let's kill the Wolf's Guardian. Getting my Dendigal Warrior killed actually turned out to be helpful because it allowed me to sneak attack Gandalf and do all this crazy stuff. Gandalf pops back to my hand. Time counter is removed at the end of the round. Draw in. Of course, now I can play as many allies as I like. So, I don't have a replacement Dendigal Warrior ready to go. Playing with Dunedain Hunter. Playing the Dunedain Hunter, if I find the Spirit of the Wild, could get me the extra resource on Mablung to just half cast Gandalf again. But I don't know if that's totally where I want to go with this. Yeah, let's stick with the points. So, 3-4 Lumpa Preserver. Now I play the Dunedain Hunter. Look at the top 5 cards. Grab a Spirit of the Wild. Shuffle the encounter deck. Gain a resource and ready the one hot preserver, which I will use to heal Beach Bone. Let's also play this Beaming Ent. And there we go. There's one threat in the staging area. I need one progress. Let's just quest for 7. As you know, 6. Okay. 3. So now, I travel to Hallowed Circle. The Raven's Guardian will make an immediate attack. It's not that big a deal. It will then make another attack later. Still not that big a deal. So let's travel to the Hallowed Circle. Defend with the Wormhole Preserver. Takes 1 point of damage. Combat phase. Oh, hang on. Ancient Forest. Effectively 3 and boosts this up to 2, so actually I only made 1 progress, but that's fine because I only needed 1 progress. So this is actually more dangerous than the Guardian at this point. It's 4 attack equal to 3, so I'm going to faint the Spirit of the Wild and Mablung will defend against the Guardian. Okay, that's a character he controls. Okay. So now let's attack for 6 and deal 5 damage. Maybe not. Let's just attack for 6 and kill the Spirit of the Wild. Need another time counter. And control N. Veronica will preserve already, so I will heal the damage from tribute. Let's play Quick Beam. Give them their own shields to Farmer as well. Just for the hell of it. And now that's quest. 2, 4, 6, 8, 11. I need to make quite a bit of progress. How much do I actually need to attack? So down the Raven Guardian. 13. 5 back damage from Beach Bone. So 8. 6, 8, right. So 6, 8, 10, 12, 15. Okay. So that's a total of 4 threatened to the staging area. I make 11 progress, 3 has to go here, then 8 here. Again. Unibang Hunter dies. Heal up. Just meddling. And that's enough. All the guardians are gone. Veronica Preserver, Rocky with Beach Bone. Now I just need to quest this out. So let's play Gandalf, drop my threat by 5. And quest for 4. 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 17. We're about to keep money character in play. You both control the key objectives because I got a good surge. Okay, so that's essentially 6 threat. This is 17. This goes to the victory display, and I win. And that's a great example of how Leadership Faramir can actually be really useful, just through the fact that when I advance the quest from stage 2 to stage 3, it's also an example of why you should always do the Trial of Strength last, because then you advance by killing the Guardian, and then find yourself on stage 3 engaged with multiple Guardians, and can potentially, you're still in the combat phase, so you can attack again. But in this case, of course, it also means I can ready my allies to do more in that one combat phase. Of course, Boomdoo Trumpeted also played a large part in that, and just Beach Bone's ability, which can be pretty crazy when you get the damage stacked up. Now, how was what I wanted to do. I was thinking about some nightmare quests. I was debating whether to do ones that I've done before, ones that I haven't done before. Actually, so I've done Nightmare Druid and Forest with this deck before, and it worked reasonably well. And that one is a very interesting one, but as I've done before. Yeah, I was thinking about trying one of the Lost Realm or Angmar Awakened Nightmares, which I haven't really done at all. What else? I've also got, sticking with the general sort of forest theme, I've done Nightmare into Fangorn with this deck before, but that one's pretty easy, to be honest. So I might as well skip over that. It's 9:30. Let's give Nightmare Druid and Forest a go, and then I might try Nightmare Intruders and Chetwood to finish off the stream, which I've never played before, so that'll be interesting. Okay, so yeah, that's fine. Okay, so that might be out of this. So, sorry about resources, 2 resources for until 5. But we don't generate resources for the rest of the game. And such things kind of like 1 copy of Garden of Poisons and add it to the staging area, shuffle the encounter deck. This kind of gain resources from card effects. Going to pay 1 resource to travel here. Stage 2B is revealed each hero with 3 resources, gains resources until it has 3. And this reveals another card from your encounter deck. Growl 2. So let's do that power like this. And control N. Okay. And take away the resources. So, obviously this is very interesting because you can get a lot onto the table straight away, so I'm definitely going to play this Warden of Healing. I will play the Booming Int, but then you don't generate resources normally, but you get the extra ones when you advance to stage 2, and resource generating effects like Mablung and Treebeard still apply, which makes this deck actually pretty good for this quest. 1, 2, 3, 4. Spend all the Mablungs. Treebeard. And then play Doomdying Hunter. So you can get this very strong start, which can seem pretty crazy, but then it's more difficult to maintain it. So I'll do resource ready Treebeard and draw a card. And end route for 3. Okay. This is slightly unfortunate, but I can kill her before the end of the round. So there's 4 threats in the staging area. Now I'm going to want something to defend against this Druid End Warrior. Or I could Phantom. Let's see, so when I engage the Druid End Warrior, I can ready the Booming Int Which could come in handy. It takes 8 to kill the dead end randomly. I suppose if I just defend with Treebeard, I could use Wounded Trumpeted to get up to 7. So that would be pretty reasonable. And actually, there's 4 14 stage in there already. So I'm definitely questing for 6. I could actually go for 8. Yeah, my running ability. Yeah, okay, so questing for 8. And Hunter, Primal Born Archery X. Okay. I need that power from Pippin. So 6. I have 2 progress, and I will obviously. Oh! Garden of Poisons. I couldn't get a resource on Medlong. Changes a lot, actually. Like, I quite possibly wouldn't have played the Doomdying Hunter if I'd remembered that Mablong wasn't going to work. And I would have spent my resources differently. This is why this quest is interesting, but difficult. Okay, I'm just going to start this again and remember that effect. So load up int. Potentially changes sort of mulligan priority as well. Because generally, obviously Treebeard is a good thing for this deck to start with. But oh, I hate this location. And in fact, I am actually going to shuffle this away and reveal something else. Okay, I can deal with this. So, yeah, obviously Treebeard is a good thing to start with, but often I would consider shuffling away to try and find an Errand Rider, a Faramir, to move resources around. Now, unless I had a Doomdying Hunter, that's obviously the thing, because I could play the Doomdying Hunter, get a resource, extra resource on Mablong to play Treebeard. But in this case, firstly, I can't gain the resources but with the Doomdying Hunter, but also I start with everyone having 5 resources. So, I can just spend Faramir's resources on Treebeard. So, let's see, Daemon the Warrior, high priority. Yeah, I'm just gonna drop 4 on the Treebeard. Faramir, let's go down the Wandering Ant as well. And then I'm going to leave it at that for a moment. This is currently 0 threat because there are no world enemies in play. So there's only 2, I'll cost for 6. Another Garden of Poisons, okay. So let's shuttle 4. But this is a much gentler start. I'll pay my Mablung's travel to the Garden of Poisons and draw in. Now, while my heroes can't gain resources and card effects, it says nothing about allies. Okay, Errand Rider is less useful in this quest because I'm not gaining a load of resources which I could be moving around, so I'm probably going to just ignore this, not actually play down runes. And even discard it. Yeah, I'm actually going to just discard that now. The Glimmering Shield could be good, but I don't think it's such a high priority. So let's just quest for level 6, 8. That's 2, 10. Although cleansing these could be horrible in the long run, but at the moment I'm okay. So 10 versus 2. This is explored, and I'll pay for Pippin to go to this garden of poisons. Control N. Move these resources out on here. Something which I'm not sure they intended, actually. So, Garden of Poisons just says heroes cannot gain resources from card effects. It doesn't specify player card effects, which it probably should, especially in the Nightmare version, because the Nightmare card, obviously, after stage 2B is revealed, each hero with fewer than 3 resources gains resources until it has 3. And one would assume that it's not intended that that should be blocked by a Garden of Poisons, especially since you could reveal that Garden of Poisons during the staging that leads to you advancing to stage 2, so you wouldn't even have control of it. And one assumes that that's not intended, that you're supposed to get those resources, but this is a card, so presumably that cancels the card effect. Let's play Darren's Wounds. Okay, sneak attack is good. Discard a booming ant. I'm not gonna get so many of them played. Currently zero threat. Quest with 10 again. Each hero must pay 1 resource or take 1 damage. I don't know if hero takes damage from this effect. It gains surge. And ancestral clearing. Okay. Well, that's annoying. But still no enemies, so that's just full threat. I'm questing for 10. I can't travel to the ancestral clearing. I'll go to the Glade of Cleansing. And draw in. Remove these resources. Add them around here. Okay. Let's play a boot and then play a demon hunter. Okay, so this guy not so much. This guy an additional cost to optionally engage Druid Ancestor. Okay, this obviously is not an optional engagement, so that'd be pretty cool. I'd dodge the surge on this guy. Yeah, I think this is the one I'm gonna go for. Shuffle the deck. Ready my booming int, add a resource to Melbourne, draw a card. Int root. Get some more ints. Int root again. Okay. Now. So a reasonable chance that I can advance the quest at this point. At which point I'll get more resources, so there's something to be said for spending all the resources that I currently have. So let's play a second Denigal Warrior and Quick Beam. Now, okay. User adding. Archery 1. So this is Archery 5, which means that the Glade of Cleansing is 5 threat. So there's 9 threats in the staging area. I actually have to quest pretty hard if I want to get through this. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 15. Maybe I won't advance the quest. Maybe I shouldn't have spent all my resources. Well, the prowl does nothing. But, so I was quest on 13. Against 11. Now I'm gonna reach this. Ready, tribute. Now, archery 9. Okay, that's really a bit of a problem. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Bringing it up to 6 attack, which is good. So, if we're talking about 3. Actually, yeah, maybe I. Let me think about this. Because I can use being trumpeted. Essentially, I might want to use it in a good way. Yeah, it was tricky because I readied when I engaged. Okay, so I'm going to reassign this point of archery damage to quickly. And take an undefended attack. Shouldn't have done that. Well, I'm allowing myself a slight rep. You know, maybe I should just take the sensible option. Yeah, except that I can't kill both enemies. I realise I'm like kind of on my shit here, but so attack, do the damage there. That's fine. Attribute defense this one, and I'll just pretend it's in staging area. Attack for 7. Kill this one. Control N. Remove resources, add a resource. So this is only 4 now. 10 threats in the staging area. I really can't afford to play anything more. Well, I could play another Doing Line Hunter. That could just make things worse. So I crossed 6, 8, 10, 12, 13 again. It's 14 threat. So I losing by one. Oh no, this is up another point of threat for higher archery. Okay, as an additional cost of option, I'm going to do that. Still have to spend two resources. Can do that. Resource, which is a draw card. Archery 9 again. That's what's going to kill me. Yeah, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Put resource to lock it into the staging area. Attack for 8. Draw N. There it is. It's extra resource. And quest for 13 again. Call 2. And all my heroes were removed from the quest. So I'm questing for 7 against 10. There's this archery 4. 1, 2. Dead. To attack, kills Treebeard. This is back down to 0 threat now. No resources. And this is now archery 2, so that's a total 8. Right, make no progress. This is done. Can't remember how it actually turned out when I managed this. But it's definitely possible. I mean, obviously, well, I suppose, ironically, if I hadn't travelled here, since I managed to get 2 progress here, obviously I would have put that 2 progress here and advanced the quest and gotten more resources, which would have made things easier because I could have played some more cards. Sneak Attack Gandalf would have been a big difference maker. So, that one little thing, and it's not necessarily like it was that bad an idea to travel, but I mean, maybe playing the Dunedain Hunter was the wrong move because it brought out the enemy with the archery, though I did reveal a different enemy. Okay, let's try Nightmare Intruders and Checkridge is what I was going to go for, which I have never played before. Obviously I've played it non-Nightmare, but Nightmare version is completely new to me. I think this is a decent opening hand. I've got my own rider. So, Nightmare Trees and Checkroot. We are playing Nightmare Mirage, nothing else. Okay, so it's just the changes to the encounter deck and a location. There's some high threat locations in this. My lack of early willpower could screw me over when it's damaged by the tolls. I avoid the surge. It's only one threat. So I do at least have Yarion to provide a bit of extra willpower. At least don't make engagement checks. Sweet fresh face. Set by one creature in the staging area. Okay. So, Errand Rider. New resource to Nablung. Play Dendingle Warrior. Then play the Undying Hunter. Top 5. Slaughter Rider. Not a great enemy to put out, but okay. Resource ready and draw a card. And oops, let's play that. Legion Trumpeted twice. And after it attacks and destroys an ally, such that you can't take discard power and victory's paper orb. Ambush and reveal it. Yeah, so don't let it destroy any allies. Seems like a solid plan. Four threat in the staging area. Let's quest a 7. Orc Abductor being the one that will be in the staging area. So well, that's going to happen. So, 6th threat, I make 1 progress. Travel to the Shrouded Hills. Because I really don't think I can deal with engaging this right away. So, I guess I have to leave it. Fend. Good damage. Oh, which one I'll play, Boomed and Trumpeted. Actually, hang on, I'll down wounds and ditch. Maybe an int. And then you have all the and so forth. So Blooming Trumpeted to plus 3 attack. So I attack and 5 points, so no damage. I attack for 7. And I have to raise my cut by 2 for the enemies in the staging area, and I have to go find Rescue Yarion. Okay. Now what? I am really going to need more willpower, so let's bring out the Wandering Ant. And then, yeah, keep being trumpeted. Oh, thanks for exhausted, of course. That's for 6, 7? Yeah, okay. I think this wasn't such a good idea. There are definitely treacheries in this quest. Oh, I'll be questing to the rest of the game. Okay. And it just changed into itself. Okay, let me just work my body. No, okay. I don't think this deck is good enough in solo to beat this quest. It's a matter of starting willpower is my biggest problem. At the starting willpower 6, which is all my heroes, and most of my allies into play exhausted. So it's difficult to get going, and this is definitely not going to work. Right? These are getting plus 2 threat each, and I have to reveal another card. A more combat-focused quest. At least I could do a bit better at it. Yeah, obviously I kind of showed that with 3 trials. Nightmare, I don't know so much. But, or just a quest that starts with less threat in the staging area. That's going to be one of the biggest issues. What's Nightmare Across the Etten Walls like? Let's take a look. Again, never played it. So my quest. Enemies not rather than specifically the sort of troll spawn. Could still be preferable. So let's give this one a try. Probably get a mark rule for this quest. That would be fine with farming. This is an ant. Okay, so a mark rule right here. And we don't need to be reminded about this stuff. An extra side quest. It's the same. Each side quest. So it's all the side quests, not just the ones that are specific to Across the Etten Walls. Okay. So there are 6 side quests and 4 side locations. Random number 1 to 6, 2, and random number 1 to 4, 3. Lilo is a pretty good one. Abandoned camp, not so great to start with, but never mind. The rest is shuffled in, and I'll have to discard until I get an enemy. Which turns out to be a set of troll spawn, which is what I would have started with in the regular version. So that's fine. And there's no longer the effect in the nightmare version where I'd transfer progress. That's not necessarily a problem. This is a case where I'm going to go do my hunter. Top 5. Giant Beetle. Once engaged with as an additional cost to travel to a safe location, Giant Beetle makes an immediate attack against the engaged player. Okay. Damage characters can't be displayed attacking your defenders against it. Don't get to draw a card, don't have any allies open and ready. But now I can play Treebeard. And then I can play Ent Newt. And we find two Ent cards, but okay. Scrap that. So, one threat in the staging area, I'm questing for lying low. Two cards. Extended offer. Quest in play. So two damage. And exhausted damage counter in play. So just do that. And one more round. Oh, now I have spray. You must either exhaust or deal one damage to it. I'm trying to deal one damage to it. Rare common. That does actually make more sense to just concentrate damage on farming. Anyway, so I was questing for 5. This is 3. Oh, but just 2 progress. Yeah, I really need to go here. Which means damage. I don't have to engage the savage troll spawn, and indeed I need rather not. So, the Fondue of the Martial. 2 damage then. Not a great start. We'll have to see how this turns out. I might be in for a short run here where I rapidly lose, but we'll see. Okay, so I am going to need an undamaged counter to defend against this, or I could faint it. I also want to kill it. I could do that with quick beam and not heal. I need to get progress on that. Okay, so upshot, I'm not questing with Mablon. Seven. Yeah. Okay, so I make 4 more progress, which is enough to explore Baron Moorland, but not to put progress on the quest. Right. I can put 8. And engagement costs have dropped, so I don't actually get to trigger Pippin. Already doing Divine Hunter. So let's faint the beetle. Then Hunter will defend against the Troll Spawn. That's one of each damage on the defending character. And Mabron will defend against the other Beetle. That's one of each. And he's dead. Okay. Something else I can try. Is there some other decent quest that I can go for? I'd like to stick with Nightmare, not give up on it. Maybe an earlier Nightmare. Oh, actually, okay. I mentioned this earlier. It's not necessarily as interesting, but it's one which I've done before, so I know that I can. Nightmare into Fangorn. So, set up. There's actually been encountered Duncan for a Fangorn enemy and puts it into play engaged with him. Okay, I am pretty okay with this opening hand. So, let's see. There's a very good one for me. Not that one. This one. This one. Yes. Will not trigger Pippin, but I can deal with that. So. At the beginning of each resource phase, the engaged player discards one attachment he controls. This deck doesn't need that many attachments. It contains very few attachments. Gondorian Shield is not that big of a deal when most of the time my enemies aren't attacking me. Entdraft is significant, but hopefully I can deal with this by the time that I want to be holding onto my Entdraft. Edge of Fangorn to the staging area. I attach my dash to it. Okay. Aerial. So no more encounter cards. Birdie start engaged with Fangorn. Job done. Time 4. That's fine. Control N. Playing True Beard right away. Really easy figure that out. So there's two threats on the staging area, let's just quest for six. That's unfortunate. But okay, so I make two progress. This would find me another one. Maybe I pick one with a higher engagement cost so that I can ignore it for a while. Yeah, let's do that. So I know there are the engagement cost ones. So that's on the engagement cost of 28, 29 with Pippin. And a 3 threat. Looks like I may have to choose a 3 threat one. In which case, higher engagement cost, more difficult to kill slightly. Let's go with this. Actually, no, let's go with this. So, I'll shuffle this in. I have to engage this one. Okay, so hinder, of course, means that these guys do not get shadow cards. And do not make attacks. So Treebeard will attack and deal one damage to this one. And I have to raise my threat by two at the beginning of the resource phase. So I'll just do that now and control N. Oh, and of course I have to remove progress for hinder. The results here. Okay. That's Handwriter. Powerful Preserver. And just question 8. So 6, I make the 2 progress. Exhaust a hero. To exhaust a hero to claim the dash. I will not be engaging this. No, don't deal shadow cards. So, oh, I should have lost time. Handwriter is another one. Draws my threat by 2. Control N. I'm not drawing the right cards. Dan's runes. Don't draft. Okay. Now. Well, let's see. I can bring in another Wyrmical Preserver, that'll be good. And Sneak Attack Gandalf. I'm probably using Combat Phase. This one that I really want to get rid of. I don't know how to engage this one. Okay, so it's question 9. We've got another one of these. Could have 9 threat. No progress. I will engage this with 1. Of course, drawing a card and readying a Wyrmical Preserver. Now let's sneak attack Gandalf. Yeah, it's gonna have to be deal 4 damage. And then attack for 8. Kill this one. Start to raise my threat by 2, Gandalf comes back to my hand. Control N. This is 10. Okay, alright, the next resource here. So 6, 12. No, I'm not gonna make this. I'm gonna have to go to stage 3. Well, okay, so if I sneak attack Gandalf and I could do more damage, but I think I want to just drop my threat. Potentially I can quest for 4, 12, 18. Okay. 18, I am screwed by that treachery. Again, I have done this before and it worked. So I'm not entirely sure what I did differently then that I'm not doing now, or if I'm just getting really unlucky. Obviously, Nightmare is a different sort of beast to regular quests. So it's not too terrible if the deck can't handle Nightmare as well as it can regular quests, but still, this one again. This. Yeah, so nothing extra. Again, good opening hand. Attribute. And quest 6. Okay. 6 versus 5, 1 progress. Travel. Do not want to engage this. My 1 progress is removed by hinder. Remove a time counter. Control N. Add a resource. Play. Errand Rider. Remove a resource. Play One Hope Reserver. Quest for 8. This one is just such a big problem. Opus 5, 1, 2, 3. This is going to go away to hinder. There's one. So I have to engage this. No attack is made, but hinder happens. I can attack and do one damage here. I have to raise my threat by 2. Control N. And the time counter is gone. Let's see, in order to engage this, I have to rotate it for 11. So I can bring out Beachbone and a Wandering Mint. It seems pretty solid to me. Now, if I were to engage this one this round. No. Not this one, I don't think. So. Nine. And it's a 6. Now I actually get to keep a progress and not hinder. Unless I do travel here and thus engage the movement. Come on. Which I'd rather not do because I can't deal with it, I don't think. The only thing is, Booed and Trumpeted kind of irrelevant at this point because. Oh no, actually, I can use Booed and Trumpeted with Beachbone because he triggers his own damage. So I can attack for 6, doing direct 9, and doing direct damage. Still not enough to take down this one. Enough to take down this one, or this one, but not the one I actually want rid of. One shot. There still might be something in that idea. So, okay. I will travel. And let's engage this. Change my results. I already beat Bone and I draw a card. Hinder happens. And then I will attack, doing the damage to Beach Bone and using Moving Trumpeted to ready him so that will take down this one. Actually, Hinder is at the end of the combat phase, isn't it? So I can only get to keep this, and start on for 5. I can trigger his ability again, so I can get 3 damage onto this wicked one, or another 3 damage onto this one. No, wait. Yeah, he's attacking for 5, so 2 damage, another 4 damage onto this one. But this one, I think, is a high priority, so 2 direct damage and 1 from the attack. I will exhaust Pippin. And this is gone. So yeah, I'm going to be going to stage 3, but I can potentially deal with that. And knowing that I'm going to stage 3, I don't necessarily have to try too hard at questing this round. So I can hold stuff back to deal with my enemies. Takes 8 kills. Can do that. So there's no threat in the staging area. Let's just quest for 7. Progress. 5. Oh, hang on. Yeah, just 2 ones in the staging area. They need 5 card effects, that's basically fine. So the hinder is going to take away this progress, and it doesn't really matter. I'm just going to be going to stage 3. But now, so I attack for 8, and I'll just leave it at attacking for 8, not bothering to trigger Beach Bone. So I'm back down to just the one, no one engaged with me. And at the end of the round, we're going to shuffle the dash into the state, into the encounter deck, and go to stage 3. What? Okay. So, time 3 on this. Okay. So, in. And let's see. Resist here. The 1-4 preservers are not so useful except for that willpower under these circumstances, because I'm not taking a lot of damage. So let's cost 9. 6 progress. So 1 goes on the quest. I'll expose that. Can I take this down right away? 10. Yes. Okay, I'll engage it. In this case, I will already actually, no, I won't ready the one for preserver. I will actually ready my own rider. And I get to draw a card for Pippin. Okay, so no attacks happen. I attack for 4, 6, 8, 10, trigger Beach Bone. There was 6 damage from the attack, which kills it. This one progress is hindered away. And control N. I will trigger 1 hook preserver to heal Beach Bone. Actually, no, I will do both of them. Alright, now. I'm going to play the Dendigo Warrior. There's the end, and let's. Yeah, let's play the Wind of Healing. Resource. And quest 4, 6, 12. Yeah, and now I'm in control. This is not going to be a problem for the rest of the game. Engage this. Sure, I can't already be done with the warrior. Actually, no. Ready the Iron Rider. Add a resource. Go with the Iron Rider to remove a resource. And attack for 6, 8, 10. Doing direct damage. Control N. This time around, I'm only triggering one Lone Hell Preserver. Observers. Yeah, things didn't come together fast enough for me to not come to stage 3, which I think I did the first time I tried this quest, but at this point there's very little that the encounter deck could do to stop me. So, quest number 12. Exit number of characters that I controls. This is not actually a problem for me. How many characters do I control? 5, 6, 7, 10, 12, 14. And particularly when I'm not actually taking attacks, it's not a problem. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I should space these out so that I can see how much damage they each have. So let's actually heal up some of that damage. And progress. I was questing for 12. Oh, but I forgot hinder last round. Which is so terrible. So I need to attack for 8 to take this down. 8, done. So, okay, control R. My well and call preservers will heal these two on each bone. And I trigger the time, so I'll discard the top 5 cards of the encounter deck. Five. I have to choose enemy or objective in the discard pile. I add it to the stationery area. Okay. I'll just go with this one again. And this one will draw me more cards. And gave it. There we go. Control. No, I don't think I'll probably hit control in there. Right. Oh, and I forgot to errand ride. Which I'll do again. Right. And that's it. Quest info 15. Oh, this again. Okay, so it'll be 15 characters now. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, 14, 15. 12 more progress that I don't need. Engage. Resource. Ready. Heal. Oh, actually, no, sorry. I won't do that. I will heal before engaging, and then I'll ready the warden and heal again after engaging. And then I'll attack for 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. And this is the thing where Huons are not a credible threat because they don't make attacks and it's so easy to kill things when they're not attacking. I can heal 3 damage with my Wormhole Preservers. So, yeah, let's just do it all from Treebeard. It has 12 attack. Did I remember to add a resource attribute yet? I don't think I did. Nope. So, move resource to Pippin. Play my third Dendimble Warrior. And yeah, this is feeling a lot like the old forest again. I'm just totally in control of everything and I just need to wait for the encounter deck to cooperate. Looking Dark Corner of Fangorn, while it's in the staging age, the one enemy loses the hinder keyword. Since I have no, and when it comes to the active location, each engaged one enemy makes an easy attack. That could be a problem if I actually had any enemies, except it probably still wouldn't be because I've got plenty of resources, not literal resources, but plenty of stuff at my disposal for dealing with combat, which I'm not using because there isn't any, so it's all, you know, ready to go. If this somehow bring more horns into play at the same time, then maybe would. Okay, so let's heal up 1, 2, and then the Wormhole Preservers will just sort themselves out. Okay, at this point I can totally play attachments and not worry about not worry about those Huons that discard attachments because they're going to be dead
Really tight, can't it? Obviously, it's again, the two attachments I have are both related to combat, which doesn't happen in this quest. So it's never going to be an issue. Actually, I'll pay for that from Treebeard rather than picking. So, yeah, you know the drill. A quest for 15. And this is fine. This is gone. I'm gonna stop putting the extra progress on there. During. So, at the end of the round, this will happen. And how much encounter? So much encounter deck to go through. This is why this is the actual reason why you don't want to go stage 3, especially if you're playing solo. It's not because it's difficult, it's just because it's tedious. So, we discard those, and I will again bring out this guy, because he lets me draw more cards when I engage him. Actually, he's not going to let me, is he? Because my threat has gone up too much. Never mind. Draw in. Oh, no. Oh, yeah, that's fine. I was thinking, no, they have to ready to heal, but that's Sylvan Trackers. With Wellingpole Preservers, just the Preservers have to ready to heal, and they were technically exhausted because I sent them on the quest. I'm just not bothering with all of the exhausting of things at this point. So. I could play Gandalf to draw more cards or just drop my threat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's just drop my threat. Since that will lead to me drawing more cards in. Cross for 15 as usual. Once in stage of the after any amount of progress is removed from the current quest, assign X damage on characters and play X as the number of progress just removed. Does not stack with other copies of Tangled Forest. I'd be interested to actually play this quest with more than one player, because then it might be more of a problem that the horns might stay in play. As it is, you just stack up everything. Okay, so technically it's these guys were exhausted. This is explored. Travel here. Engage this. And I just need to attack for 12, which, you know what? There we go, 12. Done. Start Gandalf at the end of the round. Another Gandalf. Let's play this Dúnedain Hunter. Cards. No enemies. I really. Dúnedain Hunter is actually a really great idea at this point just because it takes another card out of the encounter deck, which gets me that much closer to Moogash, but no such luck. I discard my Hunter. Okay, so now I'm gonna pay 5 for Gandalf and draw 3 cards. Sure, Gondorian Shield. I don't need it, but I'm gonna play it anyway. Wandering Ent. Preferred. And Dúnedain Hunter! We will work this time. Top 5. Blocking Horn, which its threat to the staging area once engaged with the player. It's an interesting one. Does not draw me a card. Its engagement cost is too low. I can gain resource and ready the Wandering Ent. Cost 15. That's 4. So this is explored. Engage. We are classic one. I'm just gonna ready my own rider. Okay, so this can kill one of them. And everything else can kill the other one. Got Gandalf. Remove the time counter. And like, if I was making a video of this, I would probably fast forward through a lot of this. Since it's a stream, I have to just keep going. Yeah, let's play another Dúnedain Hunter. No enemies, there's Mugash. So I think he doesn't count as an enemy, he's an objective. Quest for 15. That's fine. New round. This happens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to get the Angry Hue one out again because it lets me draw the extra card when I engage it. Angry one. This is kind of showing off. In some ways, this is showing off how this deck can function, because it's basically, once it gets going, it's very difficult to stop it, which is fitting for Ents. And obviously, it can tend to work better in multiplayer, where other decks can cover the early game, rather than in solo, where just drawing the wrong cards early on may mean that it's too much threat in the staging area, don't have enough starting willpower, or oh, this guy should have been discarded because I didn't find the enemy. Or I get the wrong enemies early on when I don't have my the warriors set up or whatever, or the Gondorian shield. That sort of stuff can cause this deck to not work. As we have seen, but in general, it tends to be fine. So, okay, Brilliant number 2, Brilliant number 3, and get ready that one, exhaust this one. Skimbark. Another Owned Rider. And draft onto Beachbone. Quest 15. Ah, this. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 15, 18, 22 characters. So I have to assign 22 damage. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So I'm going against attack 17 each. And I have explored this. So let's heal and engage. Ready, go around heal. And kill. Move a time counter. Plus, actually, in other quests, this wouldn't be so bad. This quest stage. Because the encounter deck in other quests would be going faster because you would be dealing shadow cards every round, or most rounds. But in this case, you're not. And then my running hot preservers will be a little three from Treebeard. Quick beam. I got all of my ants in play at this point. I think so. Four unique ones, three copies each of four different types of non-unique. So this is the maximum power of a booming ant outside of Rotorizing Guard, where you could get even more with the ant objectives. I considered trying that quest, but I wouldn't really be able to get the ant objectives with this deck. I mean, I could theoretically, but with only two willpower on each of my heroes, odds wouldn't be so great, and I wouldn't want to spend multiple rounds recruiting them. Quest for 15. Okay, so I'll be sticking that on Faramir. It's after time count, we'll be good. Okay, so that's the way. And I'm going to pay to ready the warden. And move resources. And control N. Remove the time counter, dealing damage to Faramir. My wonderful preservers will heal up one each from Barton each bone. And yeah. There's very little for me to be doing at this point. Quest 15. Fangorn's Anger. You bash is attached to a hero. Nope. You bash is not attached to a hero. Surge and Doom 2. Okay. I'm okay with a Surge at this point. Forest Malice each one. My attack was made as a result of the spec each player must search the encounter to discard a perfect one enemy and put it into play. Engaged with him. Okay. This is something. There are enemies still in the encounter deck, so I'm speeding up the encounter deck by doing this. So it doesn't really matter which one I get, so let's just get this one. Shuffle. Progress is fine. Heal. I can kill it. Alright, I can also heal the Undying Hunter with that warden. So this is going to happen at the end of the round. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's Mugash. He's added to the staging area. We can roll in. And when the time fighters are moved, I'm gonna check the damage. Darren's room is this room next to the resource in Treebeard. I discard this bad copy of Treebeard. Should have one Gandalf left to potentially drop my threat with. So now let's exhaust Pippin to grab Moongash, which is kind of a funny image that Pippin is the one carrying around the big orc chieftain. Okay, so now I finally get to go to stage 2. Oh no, after placing progress here. Because it was 6 progress and progress is attached to a hero. Fine, I quest for 12. And there's no one here. So that's fine. And then I advance. Okay. What's left in the encounter deck? Oh. Maybe I shouldn't have attached Nugash to Pippin. Let's just move it this way around, and that'll be fine. And like this, anything. And I have to take damage return to the top of the encounter deck. That's fine. Oh no, he should have been guarded. Which totally changes up stuff. So hang on. So we say his guard was this. So I'm actually still on stage 3. Engage this. I'll heal, and then when I engage, I'll ready the warden and I'll heal again. And then I can kill this. And control N. Use a turn counter. Is to take damage from the rest, which I can heal and pay to ready the warden. And play my third errand rider. Treebeard has another resource. And now I will exhaust Mablung to claim Moongash. And I'll quest for 12. And make my progress, and now I advance. And it really doesn't matter which one I grab, I'll take this one. Travel, engage. And kill it. Control N. With the time counter, deal damage to these two of my heroes. Heal them up again. Put an Ent Draft onto Pippin. And now let's quest for 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 15, 21, 30, 31. Regress is attached to hero. Do it to damage to that hero. Oh, yeah. I should have known that this was coming up, but. Never mind. So I'm gonna rush to the type of green card deck. Oh yeah, I was questing for 31. So there's 27 progress here. And when I remove the time counter, that happens. Find Gandalf. Okay, I'm going to sneak attack Gandalf in the resource phase to drop my threat. And then I'm going to sneak attack Gandalf in the quest phase to drop my threat. And then let's quest for 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 14, 17, 23. Guarded. Another 30 progress. Travel. And I'll be back in my hand. I'll heal. And ready, and heal again. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Play Gandalf. Drop my threat by 5 again. Quest the same as last round. That's 33. So I make 30 progress. There's another 25 on here. Move that into the soldier right there. Exhaust. Now I'm going to claim him. Anyway. 20 completed rounds. In most of which nothing important happened at all. Okay. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the first time I did this, I actually made it through stage 1 to stage 2, so it was much shorter and less boring, which was unfortunate. It's an unfortunate aspect of this quest. Okay, so that's... It's a shame that my final quest was not such an interesting one, but I think I'm done for the night now. 2 weeks' time, I will be going back to the 6AP challenge, so look out for that. I'm possibly going to be... I'm thinking about trying to update some general stuff on the blog in the near future, maybe reorganizing some of the menus and stuff. So look out for that. Line on Broken Ruins of Belagost should be up pretty soon, etc. Thanks for watching. See you all for the next one. Goodbye.